Greetings, everyone. It is I, your one and only host,
the Cosmic Jedi.
Welcome back to the channel. Boy, have I got a treat for you all. Something you are not expecting in any way, shape, or form. Maybe one or two of you, yes. And if my brother catches this video, he's the cringe. The cringe is going to hug him tight.
Damn!
It's going to hug him tight. I'm sharing something with y'all that I never thought I would share this early on this YouTube journey thing, but I was like, yo, Agasta. This is part of our childhood, my brother and I. And we had no business partaking in these types of movies. We even had a conversation yesterday. We were like, yo, well, we watched Kung Fu movies and all other different types of movies. So why is it that it feels odd to watch an Indian movie? But when I get into it, y'all will see, like, one of our favorite Indian movies was or is Gazab. I hope I'm saying it right. I think so. Gazab. That movie had weight. It hit different, man. It hit different. I don't even know where, why, or how we fell in love with Bollywood movies, but we just did.
Nice.
I remember sometimes we'd go over to our neighbor's house. It's almost like going to the cinema because, you know when your neighbor's got different set of movies than you do and it matches the same genre you're into already? Yo, I'm surprised we didn't even start doing movie reviews or movie critiques early in Nigeria. Obviously, the environment wouldn't have necessarily been prime for that, but I'm just surprised there wasn't some form of, we had discussions. Which Kung Fu movie was better? Which Kung Fu actor was better? Donnie Yen, Jackie Chan? Which one had, it's not Sammo Hung? Should you even watch Seven Lucky Kids? Shout out to, if you don't know about Seven Lucky Kids, treat yourself to watching that movie. Dude, it is hilarious. I watched it recently and I'm yet to watch it again because, boy, when you watch things as a child or a teenager, it hits different when you're an adult, but you can still appreciate, the idea they were going for. It's still a dope film. It's still a dope film, man, because it's a childhood thing. So I won't watch it and critique it. I mean, I'll make fun of it here and there, but I won't just, put it down and be like, oh, it was stupid. It was childish. Nah, it hit just right, man. But anyway, enough of my monologue and let's get into it. Yeah, you guys are going to be surprised. I'm not even, I won't even put it in the thumbnail. I won't put what I'm doing in the thumbnail. I just hit y'all up. Boom. Either you like it or not. So get ready. Ladies and gentlemen, prepare your ears for something you would never think to hear on my channel. I mean, these songs had a chokehold on us. They had a complete chokehold. And I'm still trying to process why certain songs had a hold on us compared to other songs when it comes to Bollywood movies. I don't know what magic they did in these movies. Certain songs, and by the way, let me pause. Bollywood movies now, some of them anyway, not the same as it used to be. Like this for me anyway, this is the OG days. I imagine some people would probably prefer something prior to this or probably prefer something to what it is, prefer Bollywood now than what it was before. But this is prime for me. This was just, I don't know what magic, what Ganesha or Krishna they put in this, but it worked.
Nice.
It just worked. Till this day, I'm still playing these songs. We had no business watching these movies. Some of them had subtitles, some of them had English dubs, but the concept though in the movies, they were really good. Like Gazab, I hope I'm saying that title right. That movie hits you in the feels, the action is in point, and they were doing things with like ghosts and spirits and whatnot that was we didn't question the concept, especially with Gazab. My brother and I just got what was going on. There was no like, unbelievable, it's too much, too far-fetched. Well, for me anyway, from my memory, it didn't feel like I was like, that part of the movie I wouldn't take, but the rest I'll take. Everything that happened in that movie, I bought it. I was like, there's nothing to doubt in this story. But then again, it probably parallels what we were watching as children in terms of American movies and Nigerian movies as well. But you can still distinguish between, fake and real when you're watching a movie. Like Freddy Krueger, he didn't, it was scary, but he didn't feel like that dude could pop up.
What?
Child's Play, the first one. I don't know why that scared me more than Freddy Krueger did. Because Freddy, I don't have a memory of dreaming of Freddy after watching the movie. But Chucky, I don't know why Chucky got me more than Freddy. Maybe because Freddy wasn't a tangible person in real life, whereas a doll could come to life based on Chucky's movie. I guess if a dark spirit was to possess a toy, yeah, but Chucky, that dude had me in a chokehold, man. There were times I wouldn't sit on the bed where it had space underneath it because I was worried something or Chucky would just come out and, you know, slash my ankles, the back of my Achilles heel. So I was like, nah, Chucky had me. Compared to, you would think I'd be shook up more of Freddy Krueger because of the whole if you fall asleep thing, he might get in your dreams. But Chucky, I don't ask why. Even as I'm voicing it out right now, my brain isn't processing. You can't put it together. But these guys, these stories, they just worked. Emotional beats in these Indian movies. Oh my goodness. The emotional beats. Damn. Are you listening to the beat though? Are you listening? Yo, they were not playing. Man, today. I'm always mesmerized by the composition of music, that like the final outcome. In the studio, I imagine you always have different versions, different variants of a beat you're working on. But whatever planetary alignment that occurs that just says this one, even though we've tested like 50 so far, this is the one. Or we've worked on 900, this is the one. How does one come to that point? Like how many entities are working all around us to say, you know, it's like waiting, wait, gang, that's the one right there. Did you just say gang? I did, I just said gang. That's the one right there. Everyone is pleased. The scene on the scene is pleased, you know, and then you put it together on the album, boom. Dude, the composition of these songs are fire. Absolute fire for me anyway. To some of your ears it might be irritating, and I get that, that's cool, but this is just part of our childhood that we can't erase. This, like I said, we had no business watching this, but if I say the same thing about this, then I could say the same thing about kung fu movies and so on and so forth. I can't even remember the story of this movie, but that's the thing. Dong, 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 dong. It's funny how the songs stick out and stick in the memory, but some of the movies that these songs come, some of the Indian movies that these songs come from, I can barely remember the theme or the whole story of the movie. I know Ghazab, I don't want to spoil it in case one of y'all might want to check it out, and I highly recommend checking it out. It is, boy, it's good. It's good. Just shut your mind off in terms of trying to critique it and just take it in for what it is and enjoy the story. Especially Ghazab. It is a beautiful story, man. What's this? I have no idea what they're saying, but the song is beautiful. Come on, man. Come on. Mm-hmm.
talking about Loki.
All right, then we'll leave it there. Let's go on to the next one. How do I skip onto the next one?
Brother, am I ready?
What? Dude, this one was funny. This one was funny. I think this one was about three brothers. I don't know if they were triplets, and they were split at birth. And they all came together somehow, like the universe brought them together one by one. And then I think they were supposed to take over their family fortunes or something. Maybe I think some bad guy took over the family. Split them at birth, I think. I could be wrong. One was a policeman, one was a musician, and then one, I don't know, I can't remember the third one's profession, but they all came across each other one by one, and then they were like, wait, who raised you? They were calling out names. What? She raised me. I think, you see, I vaguely remember songs, I remember for sure, but the story vaguely, and I think they all came together to then say, you know what, we need to dethrone or take down who took over our family or whatever, and they each found girls that they liked, but the father, I think the, I don't know if they're all, hold on, wait. I don't know if they're all sisters or they're all family friends, but the fathers of each girl, they were bad guys too. So these, if this one too, just like I said, I softly suggest Gazab. Check out, I think it's called Arman Akbar Anthony. Another good movie. I'm going to binge watch these ones, man, once I'm done recording this and editing. I want to see if it hits the same as it did when I watched it as a child. So this is them now at the, that's the first brother. This is the second. I'm moving my hand as if you guys can see. I was about to touch the screen as well. So this guy in him, he's one of the brothers. This one too, this priest here is another brother. So this three, basically him, dude in the white outfit. Not this guy, not him, him. Him playing. Bum, 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 bum. So now they're trying to swindle the fathers and I think get them in one area together and then take their daughters. Dude, yo, this story is dope, trust me. The story is dope. They pull off the humor well too, man.
Unhoni ko honi karte
Arman Akbar Anthony. Arman Akbar Anthony.
Anhoni ko honi karte honi.
Anhoni ko honi karte honi honi honi. Arman Akbar Anthony. Herman.
There you go. So that's the three brothers right there. But even the way they all came together and then put the plan in motion, this is them kicking off the plan right now.
Anthony.
They had no business even putting these beats together. They had no business putting these beats together. Some of them sound so way out there, like the influence as well from other cultures that they put. I don't know if this is just, you know, if this is like inspired by other cultures, but it doesn't feel like it's a Bollywood song, but it fits. It just, I don't know what inspiration they got for this one, but it still fits. Dude's a loco. I'm surprised they didn't get their ass beat in this part. Oh, I think I remember now. They were impersonating people that were supposed to be part of the ceremony. I think the daughters were each getting married. Okay, I think I remember now. Obviously, the daughters didn't want to get married who they were arranged to get married to. They, each of them liked each of the brothers, obviously. So I think the three brothers are impersonating the three people who are to partake in the ceremony for the wedding. I don't know what they're saying, peeps, but yo. Oh, that part though. No. That part was a kicker. Take it back. What? And I love their fourth wall breaking. So these guys were rocking fourth wall breaking since day one. Way before Deadpool.
What?
Other movies must have been doing it since day one, for sure. But you never really pay attention till it's made obvious, and then you look back to other movies you've watched. Damn, they were breaking fourth wall since day one, fam.
Harman, Akbar, and Danny.
Especially him at the end. I mean, come on, dude. These movies were fun, man. I think they were letting them know what was going on now. But anyway, let me leave it there before YouTube loses this shit. Like, yo, I got you in the cartoon, son, but now you playing Bollywood movies? Yo, we can't have that. We cannot have that. That's too much copyright. I think this is part of Gazab as well, is it? It is. It's a song from Gazab. And this is the one that really got my brother and I in a tight chokehold. The story, I think, because obviously we're brothers, yeah, we connected with it more on the level. Yeah, I don't want to spoil the story, but I remember two movies that made me cry like instantly. It's this one and Terminator 2.
Damn, son.
Especially the end of Terminator 2. Yeah. I probably cried whoa.
Have you ever had a dream that you could do?
I probably cried watching other movies, but the two movies I remember crying instantly without any hesitation, it's this one and Terminator 2. Dude. These movies have a special place in my heart, man. I don't know what they are saying, but it sounds good. What do y'all know about this, man? Come on, get that. Nah, y'all ain't ready for this one, man. Even that part, are you listening? Dude!
Ooh.
You just do a remake of this, I don't even think they'll do it justice. I don't think they'll do it justice at all.
आने वालों जाने वालों ठहरो लोगों, हे आगे से देखो
पीछे से देखो. Oh, those are arches. I don't even see. My brain wouldn't have saved this image at that age. But now that I'm older, I'm aware that those are two deities. Boy. That's a good point. I wonder if each of their character was an attribute, or each of the characters represented an attribute of each deity. And yeah, yo. That's why it's good to watch movies, you know, old school movies you watch as a child, rewatch them again, see what you missed as a child, man, and see what drew you to the movie, you know, beyond the veil. Yes, the action, yes, the actor or the actress and the story, yeah, but past, beyond that, what else is, you know, hidden behind closed doors? Come on. All right, then let me leave it there, because I don't want YouTube to start crying, man. Yo, one more time. If you can find it, check out Gazab and
Arman Akbar and Ernie.
I think he's teaching his brother to sing the song. I almost spoiled. Ooh, I was so close to spoiling it, man. Yo, I almost want to spoil it right now, because the story is fire. The story is absolute fire. Chai!
Deewana tera, main hoon. Deewana tera, surat meri pehchan le.
Yeah,
jaane man, jaane jigar.
It's about to kick into full. My goosebumps are on overdrive right now.
Damn!
They are on cosmic overdrive. So let me just leave this. I don't know if I start busting tears up in here. I think I got one more song left. No, that's it. Wait, I thought I had five songs. Where? Hold on a second. I could have sworn I had 5 songs. Oh, I don't have 5 songs. Oh, it's the other. It's the fifth one. Oh, my bad. The other song I had was the original song that the brother sang to that girl. Okay. So this one, the video I just played was the second song. My bad. Let me see if I can find the other one then. Janet again. Yeah, I think I've already spotted, so we good. Let's leave it alone. So yeah, if again, last time, if you can take time, watch something different. If you're not into Bollywood, try Gazab. You might like this one. You might like Gazab and Arman Akbar Anthony. And if it's too much, then just stick to Gazab. If it's like, yo, you know, subtitles or the English dub, then just stick to Gazab. It's a beautiful story. You won't regret it. You won't regret it, man. I'm definitely gonna look for it this weekend because it's a beautiful story. And I'm actually glad we even got to experience these movies because the songs just stuck with us, man. And even how we remember them, it's exactly how, well, the beat, because the lyrics, you can ask me till the next millennium, I have no idea what they're saying.
Come on, don't bullshit me.
I have no idea what they're saying, even in any way, shape, or even the Janiman, I think that's her name. I could be wrong on that one as well. I think he's calling the name, but again, I could be completely wrong. But the songs, the melody, and I feel because of the story, some of these songs stuck to myself and my brother. I mean, like, I imagine each movie had like 5 to 7 songs, roughly 5 to 7. I almost had 3, but it's a Bollywood movie, so you're bound to have 4. And those days just hit different. Today, I've seen some, you know, Bollywood movies recently. Some of them are much more action oriented, but the songs, no, they don't hit the same as they did before. And I'm not trying to say this. No, that's I'm not their target audience or their demographic, but I appreciate the originals or the OG Bollywood movies. They kicked ass, man. There's probably a lot more my brother and I watched, just can't remember the name. Like, if you showed me the song, I probably remember the movie, and then not the title necessarily, but the story to an extent. You watched a lot of Bollywood movies, you watched plenty. But to give you the rundown of every last one of them, nah. But like I said, there's something in these movies, like a good meal. The spice was just right.
Nice.
The planets were perfectly aligned, and it just stuck. Some of these movies and the songs stuck, especially the moral of the story. It wasn't just, you know, a movie for the sake of a movie. There was a beautiful, deep story behind it. There were lessons to be learned, like in any other movie to an extent, you know? Same thing with Nollywood movies growing up. So, but I'm glad. I'm glad I got to enjoy, you know, these different cultures, from kung fu movies to my people's movies back home, Nigeria. Obviously, you watched this in Nigeria. We didn't watch it anywhere else. You know, it wasn't like we went to India and then watched Bollywood movies. Watched Bollywood movies in Nigeria. So I'm glad we did. I'm glad we got a taste of that culture growing up as children, because it stuck well. It's not something I take for granted at all. It's something I truly, truly, truly appreciate, because I don't know what else to say. I think it's a testament to their storytelling or their style of storytelling, especially with musicals. Disney movies I watched, but not every Disney movie I liked with the musical. Sometimes I would skip the songs, you know. It's like, okay, we just get to the point. Whereas with Bollywood movies, I don't know. I think because some of the songs are part of the story, like they're progressing the story along. It's not like let's take a song break and just sing and dance and then come back to the movie. Like, if you skip some of the songs or part of the songs, you're skipping the storytelling as well, especially when the subtitles is on, you're reading certain things going on, like, oh my bad, the story is actually progressing through or with the song. You know, some movies, sometimes the song is just there as a side quest thing, now we're back to the story. Whereas with some Bollywood movies, I don't know if it's all of them, I don't know if they've changed it, I don't know if it's always been the same since the beginning, but I remember the ones we watched, most of them, the songs are part of the story. So even if the songs I didn't necessarily like, I had to sit through them just so the story, you know, I got what happened next. Anyway, I hope y'all enjoyed this little, should I say an interlude? Like a different road to what y'all are used to watching on this channel. I thoroughly enjoyed this one. I might come back. You know, I might come. Yeah, you know what? Yeah. I'll probably come back and do a breakdown or review or both for Gazab. And then I can do a spoiler talk on the particular song. The Johnny Man, Johnny Tiger, Johnny Tamana, Johnny Lee, Johnny Man, Johnny Tiger. I should go serenade an Indian girl with that. Yo, I mean, I'm the Cosmic Jedi, man. I could pull it off, bro. I could pull it off, man. What are you doing, dude? Anyway, I've been your one and only host. Oh, before I go, shout out to my parents, man. Shout out to my mom and my grandma and anyone else, and my auntie as well, my mother's sister, for letting us watch some really awesome movies. The cartoons, you know, sometimes mom wasn't around doing what she was doing, making sure everybody was taken care of. But we ate a lot of content. Cartoon, movies, TV shows, a lot. And I'm thankful how my brother and I turned out in terms of our character. You know, it shows a lot based on the work our family did, you know, despite how we grew up, because there's some scars there for sure. I imagine just like anyone else, varying levels, of course. But when I look back, especially with the movies and the stories and seeing life, you know, seeing people's lives or different people's lives, not the same as ours, different people's homes, their culture, their attire, how they ate their food. And just seeing similarities, especially when we didn't travel outside of the country. I feel that's another way of learning about the people, obviously, outside of your own normality or your own environment. It somehow prepares you for wherever you decide to go, especially if you want to go to China, Japan, and you're already used to their movies and their culture. It makes it easier for you to settle in the environment when you reach. But yeah, thankfully my mom or my family members, from what I remember, weren't stush or up their own rectums about, oh, you shouldn't watch this, you don't, they're not like us, so you don't watch their movies. Now, I don't remember my mom ever sitting down and having that conversation with my brother and I, saying, no, you only watch African thing or Nigerian things. Not once. You know, I mean, she too appreciated Hollywood movies. But my auntie, my dad, and yeah, y'all, both of them, that's where we kicked in a lot of action movies. My dad and my auntie, just pure action. I mean, I think the first time, the first time I watched the Tim Burton Batman, I think it was due to my auntie. What? Yeah, I think so. I think we knew about the cartoon. I could be wrong, you know, memory sometimes, you know, from your childhood, especially if it's connected to pain. When you suppress one thing, you're trying to remember another. It's like, yo, do you really want to remember that? Because it comes with some pain. Comes with some baggage, some sad memories. Are you sure you want to, you know, open that door? Because it's sealed tight. You know, you don't even know the door is there. You're right now, you're feeling around like, oh, there's a door here. There's keys. Oh my God, who put this here? Hey. You buried that for a reason. You better leave that buried. Look over there. What's there? It's gone. Where's the door? It's disappeared. The mind is a powerful thing, boy. Sometimes scent hits my memory. I could smell something, be like, yo, what the hell? And the memory just comes flooding back. I'm like, dude, from a scent? Yeah. You smelt your past? That should be another a podcast myself and Jolie the artist should do. You smelt your past. Dude, I've walked past houses. We used to eat that meal on Sunday. My aunt. Wait a minute. Who are you? Like, wait, what? I'm remembering things involuntarily. Like, I didn't, you know, like walk past the house and say, it smells like, wait, let me tap into that memory for myself. No. Like, the memory would just come like, hey, what's good? Come right here. Yeah, Sunday afternoon. Yeah. Grandma's sister. Yeah, used to play outside and then you used to eat like two bowls of rice. Yeah, your metabolism though, God, no wonder you slim as hell. But yeah, yeah, dude, just from a smell, a scent, yo. This human mind is something else, man. The subconscious and all this words for the whole vessel itself, the intricacies, the things you get to fall in love with and connect to and not connect to. This body is the beingness. It is amazing, man.
I like this one.
It is an amazing experience. The complexities too. You got physical, you got mental, you got then emotional, then you got spiritual or etheric and beyond, celestial. God, come on, man. That's why I get so pissed with so many things that it's like clogging the system just constantly and deliberately. Some people don't even know that they have the subconscious is a thing. It's a thing part of every human being. Some people just think it's body, soul, brain, and that's it. And add religion to that. People don't even know that the layers, and that sucks. Every human being should know about their own anatomy and understand the uniqueness of their own anatomy and understand the collective anatomy, meaning the base knowledge of human anatomy. Like I said, the physical, mental, spiritual, then psychological, whatever layer it is, we should all know. A Chinese should know about his biology or his or her biology, same as an African, and so on and so forth. Nobody should be coming to tell anybody, this is how you should operate. Let me woosa on that one. That's a video for another time, and it's cooking up nicely. Best believe it's cooking up nicely. Anyway, I have been your one and only host. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you I hope you take time and check out Gazab Arman Akbar Anthony, or you check out some other Bollywood movies, or if you even know these movies, what am I saying? If you know these movies, you know what to do. Type it up. And if you've seen any of the Bollywood movies that you really like, again, you know what to do. Yeah. I have been your one and only host,
the Cosmic Jedi,
signing out.
Thank you for watching.